7 News for the latest information relating to the Black experience. I'm Erin Elkins, and here are today's headlines. Our top story, President Barack Obama vowed yesterday to make good on his promise to end U.S. combat operations in Iraq by the end of August, despite a dangerous political deadlock in Baghdad and a deadly surge in militant violence last month. Obama highlighted achievements in Iraq and discussed the formal shift taking place in the disposition of U.S. troops as they transition to a more advisory role.
Shortly after taking office, I announced our new strategy for Iraq and for a transition to full Iraqi responsibility. And I made it clear that by August 31st, 2010, America's combat mission in Iraq would end. And that is exactly what we are doing, as promised and on schedule.
A transitional force of 50,000 troops will remain to train Iraqi security forces, conduct counterterrorism operations, and provide security for ongoing U.S. civilian efforts. Under an agreement negotiated in 2008, all American troops are to be gone from Iraq by the end of next year. U.S. officials have stepped up the pressure on Iraqi leaders to overcome a 5-month political impasse that has prevented the formation of a new government following elections earlier this year. In a reminder of Iraq's fragility, 2 bombings and a drive-by shooting killed 8 people there Monday. And now on the international front, Johannesburg. 18 elderly people died after a fire swept through their old age and frail care center. Paramedics said another 84 people were rescued from the Peter Wessels old age home about 40 miles southeast of Johannesburg. One of the victims died from a heart attack after being evacuated to a nearby church. The NetCare Rescue Agency said Monday that 17 bodies were recovered from raised buildings at the home. 3 of the survivors were hospitalized for burn treatment. Most of the others had suffered from smoke inhalation. Family members who gathered outside the home said survivors were rescued in their pajamas and lost their clothing and belongings. And that's a look on the international front. And now, sports and entertainment. Snoop Dogg is being threatened by a group of Oklahoma Crips who are upset with Snoop over an interview he did with DJ Green Lantern. In the interview, Snoop discusses the gang culture outside of Los Angeles and how it could disastrously affect those who are participating.
I feel like if you banging outside of California, stay there. Because if you come back to California...
Say that again. Say that again. We are nationwide,
please.
Snoop.
If
say that
you
again.
Are banging outside of California, Bloods or Crips, you need to stay there. Because if you come back to California where it originated at, we have different sets of rules and regulations that don't apply to you niggas, and you will become victim of a circumstance.
The Crips obviously took the statement as a warning because the crew decided to issue a video statement to Snoop advising him that he better reach out to correct the situation.
I'm going to tell you, I'm going to give you a pass, homie. Contact me. If you don't contact me, homie, you come down to your concert, homie. I ain't got nothing to do with it.
Looks like the threat didn't go very far. Snoop's concert went off without a hitch. And now, on this day in Black history, an African-American known only as Prince captured British General Richard Prescott. Leading an army of 40 men in 2 boats, Lieutenant Colonel Barton advanced to Prescott's headquarters. As other men surrounded the house, Prince instantly thrust through the panel door and seized the general. While Colonel Barton received an elegant sword for his exploits, Prince, the actual captor, was all but erased from the annals of history. But we remember him for a deed well done on this day in 1777. Well, that's it for us here at Black TV 24/7 News. For more information on the stories covered during this newscast, please visit us at blacktv247news.com and click on the story links. Until tomorrow, I'm Erin Elkins. Have an extraordinary Tuesday. And remember, you can catch us online 24/7.